What's up, YouTube? This is Shabazz, and I'm back with another CBD Hemp Flower review. What's up, y'all? It's Shabazz, and I'm back with more of that content that you've been wanting. I hope everybody's been safe. I hope everybody's been staying healthy. We got a pretty dope video today, but first, as you already know, I need to give a shout out to all my patrons over on Patreon. Shout out to Jesha from Lost Oak Farms. Shout out to Angie. Shout out to Wayne. Shout out to Southern Hope. Shout out to Chris. Shout out to Nathaniel. Shout out to JB. And shout out to Ganja Gav. Huge thanks to my patrons over on Patreon. Remember, if you want to join my Patreon, you get exclusive first look at everything behind the scenes on the channel. Every time I get new mail, new packages, you get to see unreleased flower products and strains that haven't even come to the market yet. You get to see merch first, all that. Plus, you get an exclusive discount code for patrons only for the merch and the legal clothing co. You also get a shout out on every video, and you get to feel really good about helping out the channel. If you want to join my Patreon, the link is in my landing page, which is down in the video description and my IG bio. And speaking of the merch and my landing page, make sure you go cop the brand new Trick or Trees merch exclusive for this Halloween season, this October. Make sure you go get that so that you have it in time to rock on Halloween. It's available in shirts, long sleeves, hoodies, different colors. Go check that out. Link to the merch is in my landing page in the video description and my IG bio. All right, we got some hot new products from a vendor I checked out last month. They have some unique stuff to offer the hemp market out of both Oregon and California. I'm talking about Flower Club. Now, if you recall, last month I introduced Flower Club to you. They are the people that make the hand-pressed hash that is made out of hemp flower. I love that. And today, we actually have some grams of hash, some new varieties from them, as well as some other stuff. All right, and they did ship that out with a letter to law enforcement. That's mandatory. And yeah, hash can be kind of dank, it can be kind of smelly. No smell on the box though when I got it. All right, so we got some hash. We got a gram of the purple gash crossed with kush. I'm not sure what purple gas is. That could be an abacus, that could be sour space candy, that could just be another kush cross itself. And then they also sent me special sauce crossed with super sour space candy. So more hybrid-y, old school mix right there. So that's dope. And then something completely new and really unique. This is the Book of Smokes. And I'm gonna tell you all about this in a second, but that's really cool. All right, before I go into all that, I wanna tell you all again about this water-soluble CBD that Flower Club has. And I told you about it last time, but I don't think people understand the importance of this right here. This right here is water-soluble cannabinoids, okay? This is CBD, CBC, and THC, I believe. Same ratios of everything like flower, though. This is no high THC product or anything like that. It has the same type of strength and THC ratio as some hemp flower. But this is water-soluble cannabinoids, meaning when you consume it, it gets soaked into your bloodstream and does not have to metabolize like food. So with water-soluble cannabinoids, it's basically an edible, but you don't have to wait an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours for it to kick in. This kicks in about 10, 15 minutes full strength, sometimes even faster, depending on how empty your stomach is. I think this is very important, and I have to talk to y'all about this again. If you are somebody, you like tinctures, if you like edibles, you're not a smoker, or maybe you are a smoker or a vapor, but you just still like your edibles, your tinctures and stuff, this right here is this is the future, this is the new age. And when this becomes more mainstream, and it's already getting really popular with mainstream cannabis, marijuana, a lot of dispensaries and stuff have these, people are moving away from edibles and going towards the nanotech, the water soluble. It has the same convenience, and nobody could know that you're using anything. There's no smell. It's the same thing like edibles, all right? You ingest this. This is actually a liquid, and you pour it into whatever drink that you're having. For example, the other day, I poured mine into some Snapple. There's a dropper right there, and it actually comes out in drops that you can measure. So it's really easy. You can put this in your coffee, your juice, your soda, whatever you're drinking, your alcoholic cocktails, if that's, you know, that's how you like to party. 10 drops of these for me is kind of like taking a couple hits off of a regular hemp joint or a blunt, all right? 10 drops into a drink. That's gonna give you a nice, light, kind of calm, relaxing buzz. But if you wanna take things to the next level or whatever, you can go to that 15 to 20 drops in a drink, and that's gonna get you to more of like a 1% type of THC, hemp flower type of feel. You're gonna get a more stronger, more potent buzz. And again, this kicks in about 10, 15 minutes, and it lasts like a good hour. It kicks in faster, but it lasts shorter than edibles, which is a good thing for many people. I know that's a good thing for me. So again, if you use edibles, you use tinctures, but you can't stand having to try to get the dosage right or waiting so long for it to kick in, get this instead right here. This is not a sponsored video. This is my honest opinion, and I'm telling you, this is the way right here. I have spoken.
I have spoken.
And I believe Flower Club is the only people in the hemp space that has water-soluble cannabinoid drops like this. And keep in mind, y'all, if you want to order anything from Flower Club, I do have a coupon code for them in my landing page down in the video description in my IG bio. Make sure you use that, save yourself a couple dollars. Let's check out some of this hash, all right? This is the Purple Gas and Kush hash. Let's see. This one came in parchment paper. Okay. We got a nice little brick of hash right here. It smells really dank. As soon as you open up this jar, smells dank, smells straight like Kush. All right, and there it is. There's a gram of hash, and this is hand-pressed actual hash right here. And just in case you're unfamiliar with what hash is, this is trichomes from the flower itself that have been shaken off, fallen off, whatever, collected and pressed together with heat and pressure. This is natural, all plant matter that's just been kind of collected and pressed and concentrated into this little piece right here. This is completely all natural and one of the oldest and most traditional ways of actually using cannabis all around the world, especially in Africa and Asia. That smells good. I love cannabis and I'm so glad that now we could get some, you know, decent quality hash, at least, that is hemp flower made. You can smoke this without anxiety or anything, because you could find hash all over the world, but obviously it's marijuana hash and it will get you high as eagle titties. Having something like this allows you, for, you know, us THC sensitive people, to enjoy hash without that crippling anxiety, panic attack, fear, feeling like you're gonna die. Now this is a special sauce and super sour space candy. This smells really good, really sour, fruity, and gassy. So there it is. And that's actually not the whole piece. Some of it fell off. But there's a special sauce, super sour space candy, hash. This smells really good. Considering the two strains that this was made from, it smells far better than both of those strains. All right, this smells dank. It smells like some old school dank, gassy MJ. All right, so definitely be trying out some of that hash here in a minute. What I'm really excited to talk about in today's video is the Book of Smokes, because this is really cool, this is really unique, and it's really convenient, and I really think some of y'all are really gonna like this. So we have two versions of the Book of Smokes right here. Just take a quick look at this packaging. There's a front, there's a spine, there's the back, and then look at that top edge right there. What's that look like? And then it's all held together with some rawhide, which I believe they're going to change to hemp wick soon, on my suggestion. So when you get a Book of Smokes, you want to unwind it. Make sure you're not holding it any type of crazy way, because there's stuff in here that could fall out. Let me make sure. And bam, look at that. So that's what you get on the inside of the Book of the Smokes. You get your matches, and then you get pre-portioned, I think that's like 1.5 gram portions right there of pre-ground flour. So all you need is some papers, and I think they may be upgrading these to include papers in the future, along with some other upgrades. But all you need is some papers. You got 4 1.5 gram joints right there, and your matches. And you could take this little sleeve out right here, so I could actually show you. So this is sealed, okay? Airtight sealed, portioned. All right, and it's already ground up, so you don't gotta do any grinding. You just take that out, dump it out, and roll you a joint or a blunt, preferably a joint. And then obviously you got your matches right there. So that is the first version of the Book of Smokes. And here's the second one. Again, we're gonna unwrap this. You got the rawhide, which I believe they're upgrading to hemp wick. All right, when you open up this one, inside of this one, you actually get pre-rolled joints. Instead, pre-portioned, it's the same thing, the same little sleeve, sealed, and you got your matches. So here's those right there, the same little thing. You actually get 8 little mini cones. Now the deciding factor of which one of these is better for you just really depends on, do you want the convenience of already rolled joints right there, or do you like to roll your own? You wanna see the flower beforehand, you wanna smell it, you wanna feel it in your hands, you like rolling your own joints. That's completely up to you. Obviously this is a little bit more convenient, but either way, this is a really convenient way to carry and use your hemp throughout the day. Because whether you have the pre-rolls or the pre-portioned Book of Smokes, you don't gotta sit there and break off of a piece of nug and grind it, break it all down and everything, roll it all in public. You either have all the work done or you got half the work done. And I actually think this is such a unique product, I'm actually trying to work a Flower Club and see if we can improve this in some way, maybe do some collabs with some other vendors that y'all love with their flower, maybe get some different art on here, some different accessories, maybe find a way to incorporate the hash into the Book of Smokes. So, you know, you wanna roll hash joints on, All I know is that this platform right here, this is so cool and this is so unique. I really like this. There's, you know, a lot of things that you can do with this. I really like this. This is cool. I'm giving you my genuine opinion. Again, the video is not sponsored by Flower Club. They did not pay me to make this review. I like this. This is a dope idea. And something else I just noticed, I don't know if you can see it, but the recycling sign right there. So this is made out of recycled materials. And if you're like me and you care about the environment, that's dope. All right, let's not do no more talking. Let's actually roll something up. All right, so I got my October rolling tray right here. And again, a little bit of hash goes a long way. Smoke some of those pre-portioned flowers. So what I'm gonna do is take this out. Let's break this seal on this top portion right here. It smells gassy, nothing too crazy. This isn't like the most exclusive indoor flower. It doesn't smell bad though. Let's dump this out. All right, and that's what it looks like afterwards. I use that whole portion. The other portions are still good. All right, and then there you go. You got the flower on the tray. Like I said, it's about a gram and a half, almost 2 grams. Make a fat joint. And actually getting it all loosened up, that's gonna make a really fat joint or like a really big blunt. I don't know. I might not actually put this all in one joint. This is really enough to roll 2 different joints right here if you're not greedy like me when it comes to this. All right, and I'm definitely gonna grab some of this hash. And if you don't know how to smoke hash, you can smoke it like flower. It's a little bit different. I explain that a lot in depth in my first Flower Club video where I just smoked this hash in a bowl. If you want to see that, go watch that video. But if you don't want to use a bowl or a pipe, one way you can use hash is just breaking it down, grinding it up with flour and rolling it into a joint. All right, and a little bit goes a long way. So for one joint, I'm gonna use about that much hash. You could use more. I don't like to be too greedy with hash because the more hash you use, the more dense the smoke gets. All right, and here is the joint that I rolled. This is the hash infused joint made with the pre-portioned ground up flour from the Book of Smokes. And what's crazy, I didn't even use all that. That's a lot of flour. That's enough flour for 2 regular size joints. This is what I have left over. I couldn't pack it in. And these are the types of joints that I smoke every day on a regular basis. I pack them as fat as possible, and this is actually 1.5 papers. Maybe I'll show y'all how I roll these in a different day. I kind of made my own method, and I didn't have any tips. Well, I have tips. I didn't feel like going and getting any tips, so I actually ripped off a corner of the letter to law enforcement and rolled that up to use as a tip. And this is all hand rolled. I did not use a roller. You can't roll a blunt like this, kind of a handmade gorilla finger cone, in a roller machine. And we already got the matches on the Book of Smokes. Let's go for it. This is the only way to smoke joints. At least 1 gram per joint in regular size papers. If you're using king size papers, you gotta get like 2. I think that's some outdoor flower, maybe greenhouse. You can taste it's not really indoor flower, but I know Flower Club is getting, like I said, they're trying to collab and stuff with other companies. I know having some exclusive top shelf flower is definitely in the cards for Flower Club, for the Book of Smokes. When I talk to companies about their products and stuff, one of the main things I'm always doing is giving them suggestions. Because I sample so much stuff, I see what everybody has in the industry, I get to speak from a consumer point of view. What would people like the most? How can you improve your product? What strains, what crosses should you make? Price adjustments. I'm always talking to vendors. A lot of the vendors you see me reviewing, I'm making suggestions to them. From a consumer point of view. Not for what's best for them, not what's gonna make them more money, and some of it will. I mean, if you make the customer happier, you make more sales, and you do make more money. So yeah, I definitely think Flower Club is making some improvements. This Book of Smokes is a dope thing. These huge fat joints, you gotta kind of puff on them like cigars. And with the hash mix in here with all the flour, like I said, it's a very rich smoke, a high volume of smoke. And hash burns slower than regular flour too. So you have a joint like this with hash in it, you might think it's completely out. But then you get to puffing on it a little bit, and no, there's an ember deep in there that's keeping it going, which is that hash. And let me tell you what. You see that? At first I thought that went out. No, nah, there's hash deep in there still lit. Let me tell you what. If you smoke blunts every day, if you are serious about cannabis, you're a real connoisseur. You really like to savor the taste and everything in your mouth. Joints are the way to go. I used to be an exclusive blunt smoker, but as I've really grown in my cannabis journey and really grown a taste and a palate and everything for what I like, joints is for sure my preferred way to smoke. Either raw papers or vibes papers. Even zigzags, I haven't had zigzags in a long time. I'm halfway through this joint, man. I'm ready for bed. I'm thirsty, a little bit hungry, but honestly, I just wanna lay down and call it a night. Hash just has just this dank potency to it that just really is just that kind of, no matter what, gives a more indica type body relaxation, body heaviness type of feeling. Hash is synonymous with that type of effect. Oh yeah, but it's smooth and it's tasty. Woo. All right, I think I'm gonna save the rest for later. Don't make fun of me. All right, I'm definitely feeling it. I'm feeling great. Very strong hemp flower buzz going on. No high. Again, like I said, this isn't a high THCA product or anything like that. So no anxiety or intrusive thoughts, nothing like that. No elevated heart rate, no panic, nothing. Just very strong, heavy hemp buzz. I feel really heavy in my eyes, feel heavy. I feel warm and relaxed all in my body. I just want to go to sleep right now. And what I actually just smoked was the special sauce and super sour space candy hash, and I'm still feeling like that. You know, that's a definite hybrid blend right there. But I went for that on purpose because I feel like if I did the purple Kush blend like that, I would have fallen asleep on camera. But even with the special sauce sour space candy blend, you know, I'm still feeling real nice. Like I like to say, toasty. I feel real warm, real crisp, you know, like a hot piece of toast, ready for some butter, some jelly, or cinnamon and sugar if that's your prerogative. You know how we do. That's a hood delicacy. So hash, that's a major go. Shabazz seal of approval, like always. And the Book of Smokes is dope. That's getting the Shabazz seal of approval, but this ain't even the Book of Smokes final form, all right? I think in the future, you're gonna see me review those again, and it's gonna be bigger, badder, and better. But as you already know, that's a unique product, all right? Not a lot of companies have stuff like this. I've been eyeing them on the Flower Club website for some time. That first time I reviewed them, I didn't try it, but I'm glad I did now, because just the platform of this, because you could put whatever flower, you could put concentrate, you could put hash, you could put whatever you want in here, but just what it is, this platform is dope. Like, I like this. It's cool, it's convenient, I dig it. And keep in mind, y'all, if you want to order anything from Flower Club, I do have a coupon code for them in my landing page down in the video description in my IG bio. Make sure you use that, save yourself a couple dollars. All right, like I said, I'm feeling good. Need to grab a little snack or something, drink some ice cold water, go lay down, go to sleep. I want to remind everybody to go get the Trick or Treat shirt. Make sure you order that now. Have plenty of time to rock it before Halloween, by Halloween. It's not going to be available forever, so make sure you get that. It's dope. That's completely hand-drawn by me. Also, if you want to join my Patreon, if you want to see all my other links, coupon codes, and again, the merch and the legal clothing code, all of that is in my video description, in the landing page, my IG bio. Check that out. Make sure you always check that out before you shop. Save yourself a couple dollars and help out the channel. Hit like if you like the video, hit me up down in the comments, subscribe to the channel, and turn on post notifications so you can see when I upload new content. I appreciate each and every one of y'all so much, and I sincerely hope you have an amazing rest of your day or night. I'm gonna catch y'all on the next video. Peace. Kunci itu nak kamu.